Hey, we're back again, taking a look at the another vintage collection, well, re-release, actually. This is Rey Jakku. We've reviewed all the others that are on the channel. You can get a look at them. All of them, five of them, are repacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So Snoke is the only new one, which we'll review shortly. But all of these reviewed, and you can check them out on the channel. This is the back of the card, and this one is VC116. This was actually the one, almost the year to date, to the day that I'm doing this. I was in a room with Steve Evans and the others at Hasbro, Mark Boudreau, and maybe 20 others or something. There's only a small handful of us. And we sat there at Star Wars Celebration looking at these, looking at the announcement of the vintage collection returning, and we were so stoked. Less so exciting the fact that these are five of them are repacks. So hopefully in the next few waves we'll get to the really juicy stuff. But in the meantime, we're getting a Force Awakens logo, which is not bad, and a nice picture of Rey from the movie looking pretty much like the figure. The figure itself, again, is a re-release of the pre-existing Black Series 3.75-inch, which was a Walmart in the US and Asda in the UK store release only. It wasn't available anywhere else, as far as I recall. This may have actually been available in Big W in Australia, from memory. I can't recall. But principally, just two or three countries, really not very many at all. And again, it's on the vintage card. And again, I've shown you the card, but there's not much else to really write home about. That's all it really is. So it's a re-released figure, which again, I've reviewed, and it's on the channel, so I'm going to go into the complete detail of it. But you do get the nice kind of extra piece where you pop off the head, and you can, once you put that through the other arm, you just squeeze it on top, and you've got a different look for Rey overall. She also comes with this little backpack if you're doing that, and that allows you to add a little bit more detail and make it look a little bit more like the scavenger output that she's got. She's also got this her pole that she has, or whatever we call it, I don't know, looking again exactly the same. So the figure's really identical. There's no major difference. A little bit of paint variance here and there slightly. A little bit more rosy cheeks on this one. Aunt Sally, if you're in the UK, you'll know what I mean, old British viewers. But the red rosy cheeks a little bit too heavy there. Other than that, same figure. Nothing different. Legs, gloves. It's the same figure, so we're getting it again. Nothing really different on this one. So maybe as we go through the vintage collection, we might get a little bit more variance on these figures. But these are so fresh from the Black Series release. They've just put them straight on the card. It is annoying they've added a little bit of sellotape on the front there for a bubble gate that we've had before. But, well, I guess it keeps your figure on the card. So that's it. Let us know what you think. We've got Snoke to do coming up next. And yeah, re-release. You liking them? You digging them? Let us know. Leave a note in the comments below. If you want to buy this figure, there's a link underneath to some places where you can pick this up. That's it from me. We'll see you for another figure in this vintage collection line coming up soon.